Welcome back. Bob Ross was at Belle Reve Country Club when the club just took off back in the middle 60s and is kind enough to join us now. Bob, thank you for coming in.
Well, thank you for having me.
Sure do appreciate it. Tell us about the difference between Belle Reve back then and Belle Reve now, because you were out at Belle Reve recently.
Yes.
Looking at the renovations for the PGA Championship.
It was unbelievable. Lisa Guile, the vice president, called me the other day and said, I want to take you on a tour.
Yeah.
So she met me in the parking lot there at the cart, and we take off. We don't go 100 yards. I choked up.
Did you?
I couldn't believe it. It's not the same as it was back then. You know, all the big tents and all the big right. buildings and the corporate merchandise tent. It's unbelievable. I had a merchandise tent there. It was about 25 by 25. This thing's about 700 feet long and about 80 feet wide.
You'd like to have a day's revenue for that, wouldn't
Ooh,
you? In your pocket?
Yeah, I'd love to have that.
And as we look at some of the pictures, it's just, you know, the trees are mature. Oh. The grass couldn't be a more vibrant green. That's a little different than it looked back in 65.
Oh, my golly. You know, we had, when we had the Open, it was the first golf tournament televised in color.
Mm-hmm.
And they had to spray the fairways so they'd look green on television.
Is that right?
Yeah, sure they did, yeah. And but anyway, today it's the routing's the same, but every hole's different and enhanced in many ways, and it's just unbelievable.
You were the head pro when Gary Player won the
yes.
Open. There was some criticism because the course played really tough for these guys, didn't
yes,
it?
Yes, it did. Yes, it did. And I played a lot of practice rounds with him and Jack Nicklaus. He's a good friend of Jack's,
mm-hmm.
and we played. And Jack was never over 68 in a practice round, and Gary was never under par. He wins the tournament shooting two over, and
right.
Jack finished about 30th. You know. So. But anyway, it's amazing.
What did you What do you remember most about Player that week? I mean, here's a black night. He's out there. The weather, I believe, was probably typically warm.
Yes.
And here's Player just moving along while other players were griping. He wasn't griping so much.
He didn't gripe. No, he just kept it down the middle and kept it in play. You know, all the others, Jack, he didn't break par in the
yeah.
tournament. There weren't too many under par rounds in that tournament. That course was really tough. And it'll probably take 15, 20 under now to win it.
Looking at Jack Nicklaus, think a long putt. You said you've played a good long while with Jack. As a young man, do you remember thinking, oh, this guy's going to be the best of all time?
Well, I didn't. I thought I would. But
you thought it was going to be you?
Yeah, I thought it was going to be me. It didn't work out that way. You know? So anyway, no, he was, as a young man, I first played with him. I was the defending junior champion in Ohio, and he had just won the Son of Hannah Amateur against
right.
all those Walker Cuppers, so they had paired me with him. He didn't play very well, and he was throwing clubs, and his dad was following us. He came up on 18. We played 36 in one day. Came up on 18. He said, Bobby, he said, Jackie's going home. He's not going to play this game again until he learns how to act. Jack never threw another club.
Is that right?
That's right, yeah.
His length in the 60s and the early 70s was just, it seemed so much longer than other players.
He was, and that's what made him so good. He was the first really long hitter that could hit it straight. You know, at 17 at Belle Reve, that was the longest hole played at that time in the Open, longest they'd ever had. He'd knock it on there in two with ease. And,
yeah.
and Gary Player and I were playing with, and Gary and I about the same length. And on 16 or 17, we'd have probably a good solid wedge to get in there, and he'd
right.
knock it on in twos. So, you know, Gary says, how can I compete against that guy? So that night we're having dinner together, and they came over to my house, he said to my wife, he said, you one of those have one of those tapes that seamstresses use to measure cloth? And she said, yeah, I got some cloth. Goes in there, and he says, Jack, stand up. So Jack stood up, and he put that tape measure around his thighs, 27 inches. He said, put that thing around my waist, 30 inches. That's where he gets the power.
That's where he gets his power.
That's where he gets his power.
We were talking briefly before we got on. What do you think it'll take to win at Belle Reve this year with these pros that are so incredibly
good? Right. I don't think there's anybody out there today that's longer than Jack was back then, but there's a lot of them.
Yeah.
There's a lot of them. You know, when I was playing, you probably had 20, 30 guys could possibly win, not the others. Now you got 125 that can win.
Mm-hmm.
So it makes a big difference, you know, and the training's so much better, and the equipment's better. You know, it's not that they're going to shoot lower scores because the equipment's better. Because Jack, I saw him one time at the practice tee at Belle Reve. He was hitting balls. And then the entrance road, as you're coming in there,
yeah.
Jack said to me, you think you think I can knock that over that road? I said, no. He said, well, let's watch this. So he told his caddy, go get a new ball. He wasn't going to use those range balls, see? Right. First hop, jumped over the road.
Oh,
now, I saw those guys here when we had, when 9/11 happened and they had to cancel the tournament. Right. I didn't see anybody knocking over that road. And that's with, you know, the new ball and metal clubs and all right. that stuff, so.
We've got about 45 seconds left. As you watch the tournament this year, do you have a player that you will either root for or will pick?
Well, I pull for Tiger. Okay. If Tiger would win that tournament, he's the richest guy in sports, as you know. If he would win that tournament, it'd be worth hundreds of millions of dollars. It'd be the biggest win of his career if he can win that thing. So I tell everybody, come and watch, because it's going to be something.
Jordan Spieth has a little something to play for, too.
There's a lot of them got something to say about it, I can tell you that. You know, you just never know in the Open, but you got some big-time competition.
And a winning score, Bob, what do you think?
I'm going to say 275.
Really? Okay, that's pretty low.
That's pretty low, that's right.
Well, good. Birdies are exciting.
That's right.
Thank you so back. Okay. Will you come back and chat more golf with
me? I will.
I like that because I love the old stories.
You got it.
Okay.
I got a lot of them.
Good. I'll listen. Bob Ross joining us now. We're back to close on Sunday Sports Extra right after this.